So I think one of the greatest epiphanies I ever had in my life seems really basic, and it might not to some seem like an epiphany at all, but it made a huge difference in my life. And you have to understand that my life for the past 10 years has been completely restricted to diapers and baby gear and spit up and poop and all this stuff that comes with kids. And I had originally moved to New York City to become famous, and instead I got knocked up 3 times by my husband. And it's been great, and it's been wonderful, but I cannot count how many times I have literally wanted to just murder my husband because of silly things. And one of the biggest thing is that we're sitting here with these kids, and there's so much to be done, and he's sitting there on the couch reading the paper, and it drives me nuts. So he still does it every weekend morning. He still does it, and I've come to a better understanding of it now, but it drives me insane to sit there and think that we could have a little time out and read the paper while all this commotion and chaos is coming, like breakfast needs to be made, and he does do these things, but yet he'll also sit down and read the paper. So I was going to buy John a Father's Day card 1 year, and I'd bought him several Father's Day cards before, but I don't know why this time was different, but I walked in to the store and I'm looking at all the cards. I'm like, oh, gotta get him a Father's Day card, write it out really quickly in the store, put it in the envelope, go take it home. And I'm trying to find one that's funny, and I'm looking at all the cards and I'm sitting there thinking, Father's Day. And all the cards kind of start popping out at me, one after the other, after the other. The guy sitting on the chair reading the paper, guy playing golf. Oh, isn't that funny how Dad always plays golf? Guy asleep on the couch. And they're all popping out at me at once, and I'm saying, it's not just my husband. Because if it was, then there wouldn't be all these cards in the drugstore depicting this dad. So he's the dad, and that is something completely different from being the mom, and that it's universal that dad sits on the couch and reads the paper. It's universal that dad plays golf, and I'm sure not all dads are like that, but enough are out there to warrant a card about it, you know? It's a stereotype, and it's a stereotype that's true. That's very, very true. So after that day, it really sunk into me that I'm the mom, and that's totally different from being the dad. And that dads are not moms, but dads are okay too. And it got rid of a lot of anger in my marriage, I have to say. Not all of it, but a lot of it. It helped me realize that I enjoy my life. You know, I enjoy my life, even though it's a lot of hard work sometimes. And that bottom line, I love my husband, you know? I just can't see him behind the paper. No, I'm kidding. No. But that's what it helped me realize, was that it's not just my husband. I'm mad at him all the time because I want him to do things my way, not just help. You know, I want him to have all the knowledge and all the books that I've read and everything that I've done to prepare to be a good mom. And he's doing it his own way, and that's okay. And I cut him some slack. Our marriage improved. I wasn't so angry anymore. And I realized that I love my life. I love being a mom. I love having a husband who is a good dad, because he is a good dad, a very good dad. And that this is just kind of the way things are in a lot of households. And that our household really isn't that different. And to just kind of chill out about it all. You know what I mean? And not worry so much about making it all perfect, because it's never going to be perfect. But it's good enough, you know? It's still special.
Bye, Epiphany girl.
Bye. Bye.